Welcome to JAT, Just A Thought R Videos. There has been a series of firmware updates since my last video, which showed my Xiaomi Yi Action camera being updated over the air to firmware version 1.0.9. Today, I'm going to perform another update and demonstrate how easy it can be. If you have just received your camera and this is the first time you're updating the firmware, no worries, the steps are the same. Firstly, you need to have the Yi Action Camera app installed on your mobile phone. You can download the app from the Mi Store or the English translated version from the Mi Forum. The links are provided in the video description. For this demonstration, I'm going to be using the English translated version, which I've already downloaded the APK. So let's just install the app quickly. Click install and it will just take a few seconds. Once installation is complete, you'll have the option to either finish or launch, since we intend to connect these two devices together. So let's click launch. And for the first time you have installed the app, they'll actually provide you some simple instructions to how to connect the camera. So let's click on this to connect the camera. You just need to click on this button over here. It will prompt you to turn on the camera. So let's do that with a long press. There'll be two beeps and the blue LED will be lit up. Let's click next. It will require us to turn on the Wi-Fi by clicking on this button over here, and the blue indicator is now lit. Once it starts blinking, it means it will be ready for connection. So let's click next. For the first time you're connecting the camera to the app, it will prompt you the ID. It will also request for you the passkey. I have not changed the passkey, so this is the default. So let's click OK. Once that is done, the passkey is accepted. It will attempt to complete the connection to the camera. And it will gather info from the camera, for example, the existing firmware version, and also set the date time to the camera. So let's click over here to get started. And just to check on the version of the existing firmware, click on the settings. As you can see, if we scroll down, the existing version is 1.0.9. Let's go back to the main screen. Now, before we start updating the firmware, there's a few points to take note. Make sure the camera battery is fully charged, or at least have 50% charge. Otherwise, it will not allow you to proceed. The same goes for your phone. You wouldn't want your phone shutting down or interrupting the transfer. Next, there should be a micro SD card already inserted in the camera. After the firmware has been copied to the camera will start beeping for some time. Do not, I repeat, do not interrupt the process by turning off the camera or your phone, or you'll have undesirable consequences. The camera will shut itself off once the process is done. So let's start updating the firmware. Okay, the firmware. Sometimes the camera will prompt you to inform you that there is a new release. If not, you can manually trigger it via the app, like this. Check firmware update. It will do a check and indicate that the firmware has already been downloaded. So let's go back to connect the camera. Click connect once again. It's attempting to connect to the camera now. Collecting the information. And as you can see, there is a new firmware version release. And it will prompt you, do you wish to update now? There's the option of cancel and OK. So let's click OK. It will first show you the firmware update that you'll be updated to, which is version 1.1.0. This is the change log, which is in Chinese. Don't worry, I'll have the English translated version in the description. So let's start the firmware upload. Now, as you can see, it's uploading the firmware to the camera micro SD card. And as mentioned earlier, please do not disconnect your phone from the camera Wi-Fi during the update process. Now, this is going to take a while, so I'm going to speed up the video just to save us some time. '95, '96, '97, '98, '99, 100. The firmware copying has finished, so now it will ask us to proceed with the update. Now remember, once we start this, the camera will start beeping for some time. Let it beep. Be patient. And once the update, the applying of the firmware has been completed, it will turn itself off. So let's begin the upgrading. Once again, I'm going to speed up the video to save us some time. Okay, there you have it. It has turned itself off after successfully applying the new firmware. So let's turn it back on. Long press, blue LED light. The two beeps to indicate that it's on. Now we just need to remember to turn back on the Wi-Fi on the side by pressing this button. And once we have a blinking blue indicator, it will indicate that it's ready for connection with the app. Here we go, it's ready for connection. So let's set it down once again. Click on this button to connect. It will start to search for the camera, connecting to it, and it won't prompt us for the passkey since we have already done the initial connection. And there you have it. Yes, we successfully applied the firmware. So let's check the version to be sure. Scroll down. And you can see the new firmware version is now 1.1.0. There you have it, easy. Now I hope you found this video to be beneficial. If yes, please like the video and subscribe. If you have any feedback, comments, or questions, please feel free to leave it in the comment box below and I'll get back to you. This has been JAT, Just a Thought R Videos, and I'll be signing off now. Thank you for watching.